So now we're going to look at scenarios involving two pools. So to prepare for a backyard party, a parent uses two identical hoses to fill up a small pool that's 15 inches deep and a large pool that's 27 inches deep. The height of the water in each pool is a function of time since the water's turned on. So here are descriptions of three situations. For each situation, sketch the graph of the functions on the same coordinate plane. S of t is a small pool and L of t is a large pool. So situation one, each hose fills one pool at a constant rate. When the small pool is full, the water for that hose is shut off. The other hose keeps filling the same pool until it's full. So if I'm looking at the smaller pool, it's getting filled at a constant rate, and it starts off as being empty. And then it stays there. So it just stops. The pool gets filled up, and then the small pool gets filled up, and then it stops being filled. So I'm going to call this S of T. Now, to show our other function, the large pool, it's going to get filled up. So the amount of water per time, if I'm looking at this, the height of the water is going to be lower because this pool looks bigger. So it eventually is going to get filled up, but it's going to start filling at a lower rate and then go past where there's more water over time. There. So I'll call that L of T. And again, the height of this pool I had is increasing lower because it's wider. So situation two, each hose fills one pool at a constant rate. When the small pool is full, both hoses are shut off. So to describe that, we would have our same kind of graph here. We went here, the hose is kind of shut off, and then here would be S of T. Now how this one is different, L of T, the pool is getting filled, but the height is at a smaller rate because it's wider. It then just stops. So both are shut off, so this height stays constant too for L of T. So let me erase that part. I did not need that parenthesis. So now we're going to look at situation three. Each hose fills one pool at a constant rate. When the small pool is full, both hoses are used to fill the large pool. So remember, our small pool would get filled at a constant rate, then just kind of stop. So this is S of T. Now the large pool starts off at that slow rate, but then all of a sudden this hose is added. So the slope of the graph would increase because more water is added over time at a constant rate until it gets full.